Our next topic is map projections. As mentioned previously, it is impossible to take the curved surface of the Earth and portray it completely accurately on a flat piece of paper. So maps, especially small-scale maps of the entire world, have inherent flaws. That means they have distortions. For example, small-scale world maps cannot simultaneously maintain proper size and proper shape. Thus, map makers are faced with the challenge of trying to minimize distortion so that any distortion present does not impact the ability of the map to fulfill its purpose. Map makers use map projections to transfer the rounded system of the Earth onto a flat piece of paper. We will see that there are many types of map projections, but none is suitable for all purposes. Rather, each has its own best uses and its own pros and cons. Although there are hundreds of different types of map projections, we can lump many of them into one of the following four families of map projections: cylindrical, planar, conic, or pseudo-cylindrical. Projection types are named based on the system that is used to project the parallels and meridians onto the flat map. Nowadays, of course, computers are used rather than projection equipment. But the concept of a projection helps us understand how different projection types are created. Notably, all projections show location, latitude, and longitude correctly, though the projections differ in their ability to show proper size and shape. This figure here shows theoretically how a cylindrical projection could be formed. You could take a light bulb inside a model of the Earth, wrap a piece of paper in a cylindrical form around the globe, and then project the lines of latitude and longitude onto the paper. From the results shown here, you can see that size is terribly distorted. Go back and look at a globe and see how big Antarctica really is, or how big Greenland really is. They are much, much smaller than depicted here. Here, Greenland looks like it's bigger than South America and nearly as big as Africa. But in reality, it's about the size of Mexico. And you can fit many Greenlands into Africa. Notably, maps that distort size, such as this one, would not be good for uses that require us to compare sizes around the world. If we were trying to map the distribution of a particular type of forest cover or a particular type of land use, for example. Similarly, maps that distort shape would be a poor source for uses that require a detailed analysis of shape, like precise country borders, etc. Before we show the examples of the different families, let's actually review two additional terms first: equivalence and conformality. Equivalence and conformality refer to a map's ability to portray size and shape. Some maps are considered conformal, some equivalent, and some are compromises of the two. Equivalent maps are able to show size correctly through all regions of the map, but shape is sacrificed. On the other hand, conformal projections are able to maintain shapes in all parts of the map, but size is sacrificed. So in this example shown here of this cylindrical projection, which is it? Is it equivalent or conformal? What is shown accurately, size or shape? Hopefully you said shape, and indeed that's the case. Even in the word conformal, you have the word form for shape. So here the shapes on the map are fairly accurate, but size is terribly distorted. So again, to review, an equivalent projection, sometimes called an equal area projection, is able to maintain equal area relationships in all parts of the map. You can use the same scale in all parts of the map. However, shape is distorted, and it often looks quite muted. You don't have the same level of detail for shape. Conformal maps, on the other hand, maintain the proper angular relationships, so shape is fairly accurate. However, size is terribly distorted, especially farther from what's called the standard parallel. As a hint, you can often tell if a map is conformal, or actually even a cylindrical projection, because the parallels and meridians are arranged at 90-degree angles everywhere throughout the map. And you know from looking at a globe that it doesn't really look like this. All the meridians generally converge toward the poles. This is why size is so terribly distorted near the poles. The Mercator projection shown here is a cylindrical projection. That's a great example of a conformal projection. It does a great job with shape, but it distorts size terribly. Unfortunately, the Mercator projection was used in elementary school, middle school, and high school classrooms all over the United States for many decades. Thus, several generations of schoolchildren grew up with really distorted ideas about the sizes of different land masses on Earth. In particular, they would tend to underestimate the size of Africa and South America, and dramatically overestimate the size of, say, Canada, Greenland, and Antarctica. All right, so which one of these is conformal and which one is equivalent? And what does that mean? What does each map do a good job with? And what characteristic is distorted? Did you get it right? Hope so. Notably, many projections are compromises. They're neither 100% conformal or 100% equivalent. This is an example. This is the Robinson projection, and it does a pretty good job with both shape and size, though neither is 100% accurate. On the next few slides, I'm going to show examples of each of the four families of projections, but you should definitely review your text to note details on each. For example, you should know their strengths and limitations, and what regions of the world this sort of projection would make sense to be used in. Also, pay attention to how much of the Earth can be shown on each type of projection. Some projections only show half of the Earth, or less. Also, be sure to read in your textbook a little bit more about the Mercator projection, its uses, for which it is very good, and also its flaws. All right, so I have a slide for each family of projections. You should pause the video and study each one.